Diarrhea. Today we will discuss a case of diarrhea. When a patient comes to your clinic with an acute attack of loose motions, what should we do? The first thing you should ask is the type of motions, whether it is watery or whether with mucus, and ask the frequency. Also, ask about associated abdominal pain, vomiting, fever, and ask about urine output. Mucus or blood and mucus in the stools usually means amoebic dysentery, while watery motions means bacterial dysenteries or gastroenteritis. If the patient has watery motions, he may get dehydrated very fast. So you should be very careful in assessing the patient and look for dehydration if the patient has watery motions. Now, how do you assess for dehydration? If the pulse is fast or feeble, or if the blood pressure has fallen, then dehydration is severe and it requires rapid infusion of IV fluids. If the patient feels that the urine output is reduced, dehydration is severe. Look for sunken eyeballs, dry tongue, thirst, and loss of skin turgor, which are other signs of dehydration, which are of more importance in children. Now coming to the treatment, let me first discuss the patient with mucus dysentery, that is mucoid stools, semi-solid or loose stools with lot of mucus and sometimes with blood. The standard treatment is to give tabtinidazole 500 mg BD for 5 days or ornidazole 500 mg BD for 5 days. You may also prefer tabsecnidazole 1 gram 2 tablets stat or tabflagyl 400 mg TDS for 7 days. Now, which is the better drug? All are effective, though I prefer tinidazole or ornidazole. The choice also depends on patient's tolerance. Some patients get lot of bad taste and giddiness with one drug, but tolerate the other drug better. So if the patient does not tolerate one drug, you can always try the other with equal effect. So for amoebic dysentery, give tinidazole or secnidazole or ornidazole. But if the attack is severe, or if there is associated fever suggesting bacterial infection also, then combine it with an antibiotic like ciprofloxacin or ofloxacin. Here you may prescribe the combination drugs like cipro plus tinidazole or ofloxacin plus ornidazole, which will take care of the mixed infection. Apart from these anti-amoebic drugs, what other drugs will we be giving? If there are colicky pains or cramps in the abdomen, prescribe an antispasmodic like tab-enafortan or spasmoproxivon. And if the pain is more severe, give injection enafortan 2cc IM stat. For reducing the frequency of motions quickly, give 2 tablets of Lomotil or Lomofen stat followed by 1 to 2 tablets TDS. To reduce the metallic taste and nausea of anti-amoebic drugs, give an antacid like Digin and Ranitidine or Omez with Domperidone. In addition to this, advise the patient to take sufficient amount of fluids and a simple diet, avoiding oily fried foods, chilies and milk. Take just soft diet and liquids like soft rice, ganji, bread, etc. Now we will discuss a patient who has watery motions. Watery motions means loss of fluids, dehydration, fall in blood pressure, so a serious problem. And secondly, watery motions means bacterial infection, so the stress of treatment will also be on intestinal antibiotics. So essentially, the approach differs when the motions are watery. Keep in mind that watery diarrheas are potentially dangerous and can even be life-threatening, especially in old people and infants in whom dehydration sets in very fast. If there are only 4 to 5 watery motions in a day, BP is normal and the patient is generally well, then he may be prescribed medicines and given instructions and called for follow-up next morning. But if the frequency of motions is more, if there is vomiting or if the blood pressure has fallen, there is tachycardia, then the patient must be admitted and given fast IV fluids and IV antibiotics. Now we will come to the actual treatment. First, let us consider a patient in whom the watery diarrhea is not very severe. There are 4 to 6 motions in a day and no visible signs of dehydration. Replacement of the lost fluid is the first and most important thing. Prescribe ORS, that is oral rehydration solution, like Raylite, prepared in boiled and cooled water. Ask the patient to drink plenty of ORS along with other drinks like rice ganji water or buttermilk, both with a pinch of salt, or coconut water or black tea. If the patient is unable to take sufficient fluids orally, say due to vomiting, then do not hesitate to give IV fluids. Give DNS or Ringer lactate. Secondly, prescribe an antibiotic, preferably ciprofloxacin or gentamicin. A locally acting intestinal antibiotic like cap-neomycin 2 TDS should also be prescribed. That is for local action. Many of the watery diarrheas are viral and do not need antibiotics. But in general practice, one does not take chances. And ciprofloxacin or gentamicin should always be given. In severe diarrheas, higher antibiotics like cephalosporins will have to be given. Thirdly, to reduce the frequency of motions, give tab Lomotil or Lomofen 2 stat and then 1 to 2 TDS till diarrhea is controlled. When these drugs reduce the motility of GI tract, more fluid from the lumen is absorbed and loss of fluid is restricted apart from the symptomatic relief. If the patient has colicky pains in the abdomen, give an antispasmodic drug like tab Enafortan 1 TDS. Tab Resecodatril 100 mg TDS is given as long as stools are watery to reduce the watery secretions from the intestinal mucosa. Lastly, we have to keep the intestinal flora back to normal. So give lactobacillus preparation like cap-neutrolin B 1 TDS or Econorm 250 mg sachet 1 TDS. Apart from this, accompanying symptoms should also be treated, like fever with paracetamol, vomiting with Perinorm or Ondansetron. Once diarrhea is controlled, the patient can take more of soft but bland food, like ripe bananas, bread and biscuits, fruit juices, soups. Then next day, toast, ganji, soft rice, idli, cornflakes, fruits and such soft diet. But the patient must avoid milk, aerated drinks, chilies and deep fried foods. Now we will come to a patient who has a severe watery diarrhea with dehydration and hypotension. If the blood pressure has fallen below 90 mm systolic, you should consider the patient's condition as critical. Leave all other work and start an IV drip of Ringer lactate with a 18 number scalp vein needle or a Venflon cannula. If the veins are collapsed, use a 20 number needle, but not 22 or 24, because you have to push the IV fluids really fast and you must have the largest bore needle in the vein. Now raise the IV stand high and let the fluid run very fast. If BP is on the lower side, attach a 3-way and a 20cc syringe and push the IV fluids fast till BP comes up to 100 mm. You may have to push 2 to 3 bottles of fluids or even more very fast. After pushing in some fluids, give IV Decadron 2cc, IV Mefentin 2cc and IV antibiotic. If after pushing 3 to 4 bottles of fluid, BP does not still rise, then shift the patient to a hospital immediately, unless you have practical experience to handle such serious cases. They may need up to 10 to 20 bottles of IV fluids and will need monitoring of all vital parameters. They may go into renal failure or electrolyte imbalance. So it is advisable to send them to a physician for further management. The common question is, which IV fluids should we start? Give Ringer's lactate or glucose saline or normal saline, but not 5% dextrose. Always you have to give an electrolyte preparation. Remember, never start 5% dextrose for a patient with diarrhea and dehydration.